Hello and welcome back. So in today's video, we're going to be talking about preparing for and nailing interviews. Now, see, it's not just about getting a job, you know, it's about getting a good job, a job that makes you happy. You know, sometimes irrespective of the pay, you are happy with what you're doing. The thing is, what kind of person are you? Are you the person that's working because of money, or are you the person working because of experience? Are you working because you just want to get out of the house? There's no bad thing about any of these three things, or whichever category you are in. The thing is to understand whom you are and exactly what you're looking for. That way, whatever you're searching for will be in tune with whatever it is that you actually need. So there are two key things to keep in mind while preparing for an interview or a supposed job. Now, the first thing is to study the dictates of the particular position that you are applying for, and then the second thing is to study the company or your employer. Now, by study, I mean like dictionary meaning of the position you are applying for. If you do not understand what a particular position is about, how would you nail the interview? So you have to go online or open your dictionary and understand the meaning of a company secretary or a company assistant or whatsoever it is, so that you don't find yourself applying for the wrong job. Studying the company, you have to study the portfolio of the company. Go online, find out what is this company actually about. Are they really in tune with the vision I have for myself? I won't go and be applying for something that has to do with catering when I actually want to do manicure and pedicure. You get my point. So you have to study the portfolio of the company, and by portfolio I mean like what works they've done in the past, what works they are in the present doing. Now, for lawyers, are they still in litigation? You know, do they have a pending case in court? Now, one pertinent thing I want to mention is looking at a company's rate of adverts. Is it a company that puts out adverts every month or every week? You know, check out the reviews and check out everything being said about them, like what's their personality or what they're being looked at as online. Because like I said earlier, it's not just about finding a job, it's about finding a good job. Check if they have bad reviews or bad ratings, because if you find yourself rejecting a job you actually really liked because of a money promised to you somewhere else, and you're getting to that place and you're seeing the exact opposite, you would actually really be hurting. So while they are going to interview you, you should interview them. You get my point. You should research about them, find out, are they always in court? You know, are people always suing them? Are they always hiring and firing? You know, people like that, you don't want to find yourself working there. Now, this is a job position, because somewhere on the screen you're going to be seeing what I am actually doing on my laptop here. So this is a position I saw on for the position of a company secretary slash a company legal advisor. So now, if you're a lawyer or a law student, you're just coming out from the law school or NYC, you guys get my point. You know the job of a secretary and a legal advisor. And if you do not know, go back to your textbook and find out the meaning of what this job entails, because sometimes what a layman or what the literal dictionary is going to explain to you is the meaning of a secretary might not really mean what the law has depicted or has told you is the meaning of a secretary. You know that a secretary is supposed to file annual returns, a secretary is supposed to handle the change of directors, minutes of the meeting, the secretary is supposed to arrange for annual general meetings and all whatnot that you have. Cover letter. Now, the cover letter should reflect the terms of the contract and employment in using with your thoughts and your experience and your plan. You know, it should express yourself and the company based on your research. In units, they should come together and form a cover letter. Now, we're going to go into that. So now, you know, this is the definitely you should have your title properly addressed to the particular position it is that you're applying for, your number, your email, all those parts are not really, we're not talking about the structural arrangement of what your cover letter should be. Now, we're talking about the content of what your cover letter should be. Now, So, for the introduction, I introduce myself. My name is Miss Imejumi Shalom. I'm writing to you regarding the application of the position of a company secretary / legal advisor in your company. You tell them where you got the information from. I got the information of this vacancy from a job recruitment website called Jubu. You know, I'm a graduate of Nnamdi Azikiwe, blah, blah, blah. State yourself. You're just introducing yourself to the company. Now, the second part, I'm trying not to make this video very lengthy. Now, the second part is to give a general review of the things that you can do that relate to the responsibilities in the advertisement whilst being honest. And by being honest in the fact that you put things you earnestly can do and then you put things that you are actually willing to learn along the line. Okay, now, so you can take a screenshot at this point to just properly understand what I have said here. As you can see, I wrote here, I am aware that your company offers top-notch services in real estate. That is why I said you need to Google the company. You need to understand, even if you have to do a company search through a lawyer, as long as the job is important for you. I'm not saying you should do that, but you get my point. So therefore, I know what is required of me to do. I know what is required of me to do in order to make the functions of the company, to make sure the functions of the company are carried out effectively. I have particularly created an effective ebook that can help a real estate company get clients that stay over the course of many years. Now, you see, you're telling them your skills that particularly relate to the position that has been put out, okay? That is why you see you have to be working on yourself so that you have something to offer in case of job interviews or job ads. You'll be telling the company what you can do and what you can do that will benefit them. Like I said, it has to be in unison with the advert that's being put out. So, the next are your plans for the company based on your research. You know, in the event that they hire you, just keep putting it out there. If you hire me, when you hire me, before they forget that they have not hired you, and start smiling. Okay, so getting back to the video. Okay, so I sincerely wish to be part of your company's solid team by channeling my experiences, skills, and research to the propelling of your company's achievements, particularly in the areas of mortgage. Now, you see, you study the company, you know they are into real estate, they've delved into leasing, tenancy, and all whatnot. Now, you look for the areas they're not so strong in and offer them a solution, that you are the solution, you are the reason why they would expand, you know, their horizon, broaden their branches. Now, I researched about this particular company and I realized they are not really into mortgage and all. And so I say, I have an experience in mortgage. Don't lie, but still say things that you have not done, but you can do. I'm sure you get my part. I will say, I sincerely wish to be part of your company's solid team by channeling my experiences, skills, research, the propelling of your company's achievements, particularly in the areas of mortgage, which I noticed the company has not delved into yet, while developing myself, of which I know this distinguished company will afford me the opportunity to do so. I hope you get me. Going into the preparation of your CV. Now, your CV and your cover letter have almost the same nature. The major difference between your CV is the listing nature. You get, you know, you list, you're listing things about yourself. I am this, I have done this, and I have done that. You know, you get my point. While tailoring it to suit the already put out advert. You get my point. So, going right into the CV. I'm sure we already know what this structural part of a CV entail. What I want to talk about majorly is your responsibilities and how to write them to properly depict what is required of you in the put out advert. Okay, so now for your work experience, so you see, studying that is a company secretary / a legal advisor position that I'm vying for. So I have tailored most of my works to suit that of a company secretary. Not to say you cannot put everything you've done, but chronologically arranged according to purpose of the advert. Do you understand? If you're a caterer and you are looking for a cook, you put catering under cooking. Do you understand? So for the company secretary, those are, if you understand what the job of a company company secretary entails. So these are my responsibilities in this firm. So I called the first firm, and the thing is, you mustn't arrange your CV according to, you know, chronological year arrangement. What I mean is, like, how early did you, how presently, like, you know, they always say a CV, you start from present to previous, but I would say you arrange according to importance. Okay, if you're working as a caterer in 2020, obviously your 2019 job as a litigation officer or a company secretary comes before whatever it is that you're doing now. So according to what is important for the particular job you're vying for, you put that position first. That is how I like to arrange mine. So as you can see, I work for a digital law firm, so legal advisor, which is in tune with the position being set out for corporate body registration, corporate body post registration duties, drafting legal agreements, article writing for blog page of the website. Now you see, I have channeled my work experience to be in tune with the work of a legal advisor slash a company secretary while training a pinch of myself. So now I've told them I can do all that you've asked me to do, and I can also run your blog. So you see, more money possibly. I'm not saying always works, but that is more money or more respect for you. Okay, so now XYZ Partners, 2019 till present, responsibility, minutes writing, as I was saying, to suit the particular job. You can know, at this point, you can take a screenshot so that you properly understand whatever it is I am saying, and these are my trainings and whatever. So the thing people forget to put sometimes is your knowledge of software or your knowledge of computer. Now we are in a different age. This is 2020. Everything is going online, so don't forget to put every knowledge about the computer you have, no matter how small or silly you think it is. Are you good with Microsoft Word? Are you good with PowerPoint? Are you good with Excel? Whatever it is, just catch it properly. Use a very good English to properly depict that you actually know what you're doing. And then throw in your other skills. As you can see here, I put that I'm a creator on my YouTube channel, on my Instagram, and I create content for people in the legal world. Okay, so your skill, I shouldn't be saying I like makeup or I do very good makeup videos when I'm vying for the position of a secretary. I cannot emphasize that enough. Okay, so if you notice in the position, you can go back at this point or you can check later, I am going to put these my other skills to suit that position. Like I keep saying, it just has to be always tailored to suit the particular position that you are searching for. So excellent communication skills and feedback, because in that place, in the advert, it was said that I would be liaising with other officers, so they need to know that you are very good with communication. If something happens, you have the information ready and you're telling who it is that you're supposed to be telling. If they send you on an errand, you're ready to give feedback. So I put it as my number one. And then presentation skills, definitely as a secretary, you know what is required of you. Ability to work with minimal supervision, good computer knowledge and all that. And my hobbies should also depict whatever it is that I am vying for. So if your work entails something about getting clients or getting people to do things, I suggest you add percentages and numbers. That way you show them like how much sales you brought or how many clients you brought. You know, work with numbers and patience. I'm not very good in numbers, so I wouldn't go for a job that requires certain things. So aside from the cover letter and the preparation of your CV, the next thing is to pay attention to the instructions that are given to you. If you are asked to send your application via email, you do the same. If you are supposed to do certain things before a deadline, you hearken to the deadline. If you're asked to bring your certificates, you bring your certificates. But I advise you go with the photocopies of your certificate, because anything can happen and the originals of your certificates are lost. So except you are asked to bring the originals of your certificate, I advise you go with a photocopy of your certificates. Then always go with passport photographs. You never know when they come in handy. We'll be making another video on your appearance, which is actually my favorite, and I think it's a much easier video to make. I hope this video proves